Well, my name is Des Bishop, and I'm from New York and Ireland. It's very confusing. My show is called Des Bishop Likes to Bang, and it's on at the Assembly Gardens at 8:50. George's Gardens. Very confusing this year, with all the different assemblies going around. Assembly, continuity assembly. It's more confusing than Irish terrorism. Well, yeah, this is, seventh or eighth fringe, fourth in a row. And yeah, it's great. I mean, this year particularly, because we got good shows and good weather. Very rare you get that mix. Oh God, I don't know if it's really changed that much, to be honest. A lot of people like to claim it does, but I think they're looking for something to complain about, to be honest. I don't know how much has changed. I mean, I guess there's maybe bigger names keep coming back, maybe. But yeah, I couldn't really say how much. The only thing that's changed about the Fringe is I enjoy it now, whereas it used to be a bit of an endurance test. Because I was shit, really. I wasn't as funny as I thought I was, you know. And I'm much more comfortable in my own skin now. So if I perceive any change, it's more that I've changed myself, so I perceive the world a little bit differently. But yeah, and I guess, you know, it moves around a bit and there's different spots. There's definitely more, you know, years ago, it used to just be the Pleasance had the cool sort of outdoor vibe. Now there's like seven good outdoor vibey places. So I'd say that's one big change, which I have to say I kind of like. Because I don't drink and I find like the sort of dingy, you know, like artist bars to be a bit boring and meaningless for me. So I quite like the sort of Assembly Gardens vibe or, you know, like, in, you know, by the Purple Cow. I like that change. In the back of my mind, there's always this, like, there's going to be a lot of reviews for this show, you know, like, so if I think a reviewer's in, I don't want to, but I think a little bit more about what I'm saying. I try to make sure that it's got a bit more depth, or it's not as easy a laugh, you know, maybe a more challenging laugh. Whereas, like, say if I'm touring in Ireland and I'm playing Boyle, County Roscommon, and I know that, like, it's just fans of mine and nobody's going to be there, I'm probably a bit sort of looser with the stuff that I talk about, not as concerned. So I'm probably a bit more critical of the stuff that I do when I'm in Edinburgh, and I probably, because it's a predominantly middle-class white festival, unfortunately access to the festival seems to be pretty rigid, I tend to focus on you know maybe issues that are a bit more challenging to, like, for example, I have a rap about organic food in my show. And I probably wouldn't do that rap in Ireland. I just feel like my sort of more broad fan base in Ireland just really couldn't give a shit. Whereas here I feel like that's a good thing to talk about because some people are quite obsessed with organic food. A lot of people don't eat wheat or dairy now. It's kind of like a middle class concern. So I'd probably focus on something like that more than I would say in Ireland. Not to say that my fans are stupid in Ireland. You know, you just want to make sure you're engaging with things that matter. You know? Yeah, Edinburgh probably has the most variable energy you could possibly imagine. I'm waiting for a scientist to do a study on the dynamics of the Edinburgh crowd, because, so 2 years ago, my show was about my dad, so I had this opening that was on video, so it was completely the same. It's like, it was a constant, no variation, no variable. Just the same video every night with the same jokes, and every night the reaction was different. And that was a very good run. Every night was sold out. So same number of people in the room, different reactions every night. Like, how do you account for that? Is it the weather? Is there more English people on a particular night? They tend to be a bit more, you know, downbeat. Is it more Scottish and Irish? They tend to be more upbeat. Like, what is it? If somebody could figure out why there's such a variation in Edinburgh more than anywhere else, I'd love to know. Possibly tiredness, the amount of shows people have seen, nights of the week. But it doesn't follow a formula. You can never figure it out. Like, some nights, you know, when, like, in some venues, the usher or the venue staff come out and say the fire exits are here and all that, like, some nights they get a round of applause and some nights it's like dead silence. Like, why does that happen? Their performance is the same too. They're not really looking for a round of applause, they just get one. Like, last night my venue manager got a round of applause. I was like, oh yeah, this is gonna be a good one. The venue manager's killing it.
One minute.
Oh, I'd say, well, it's great fun. Sometimes people get up and dance if you like hip-hop with some really good jokes in it, and some material about things men don't like talking about, then you should definitely come along and see the show. It's probably one of the best closers in the entire Fringe. That's what I would say. But only when asked to say it. In actual fact, I would never say that. I would just be like, you know, you should come see my show. Oh, you're busy? All right, don't worry about it. Thanks. Thanks a lot.